All right, what's up, guys? We're here with a deck profile from the Dallas Regional. So why don't you tell us who you are and what you're playing? And it might be something different this time than what we're typically used to.
I'm Roberto. You know who I am. I'm on the channel all the time. Jordan's a tag duel champ partner.
Tag duel champs.
I played Draco Slayers at the Regional.
So why'd you decide to play Draco Slayer over something like maybe like Tear or Sprite?
I just really like the pendulum mechanic in general. And I like the deck. I like what it does. Does some unfair things, but I think maybe I just wanted to challenge myself because Sprite is really easy.
Tom's in the background trying to make fun of him or something like that. All right, well, let's see this deck list.
Okay, so best card of the deck, triple Modern Revolution, searches your Luster, searches Magister, revives any of your Draco Slayer extra deck monsters. This card's insane, not once per turn. And depending on what your other scale is, you can pin summon out your Goliath or your Sloth, whichever one you're playing, and just keep looping it with the fusion. Triple Bunbuku. This searches you Majesty, which is like your best Draco Slayer in the deck. It's insane. Can't be targeted, so they can't imprint it. They can't Celiac it. They can't destroy it, so it's pretty good. Also, it's another high scale. Three Ignis. This card's good. You normally just pop it with like Majesty or Luster to get a summon, and you're normally summon Majesty so you can get the field spell. But just basically when it's destroyed, it summons another Draco Slayer from the deck and it's treated as a tuner. So you can do weird plays where you're making Savage and stuff like that. Three Majesty is the best one. It just searches a Draco Slayer and then you get an optional pop of the scale, so you don't have to. But it's really, really good. And then when it's summoned, you search for a field spell. And then also has another effect of if it's in hand, you can discard it to make it to where they can't target any of your Draco Slayers or destroy them by card effects.
Dang, so y'all got a miss too?
Yeah, so we got a miss as well. And ours is at three. And it's a Rota, which is crazy. Three of the second best Draco Slayer down this one. People kind of sleep on this card, but this card's incredible. Whenever it's in scale, you can just summon another one. Another Draco Slayer or Dynamis from your other scale. And then whenever it's tributed, you add one from extra deck. So you're always like adding back your Majesty for protection to discard. And if you don't need to, then you just have a free low scale in hand. So pretty crazy. Third best one, your Luster. This card's insane. Just pops the scale, adds another copy of it. So popping your Ignis or popping your Dynamite, whatever you need. It's pretty crazy. And then Double Magister. This one's okay. You just need it because sometimes it comes up the extra name and being able to pop your Ignis just while it's in scale.
Did the extra name ever come up?
The extra name came up a lot. The only time it doesn't matter is when you need to make like Beyond the Pendulum or something that needs effect monsters like Zalantis because you have to use a different one. But most of the time I was using this to make the seals at the very end of the combo.
Whoa, spoilers for the extra deck.
True. The Performer Pal package, Joker, Dissolver, and Monkey Board. A lot of people aren't playing Monkey Board or Joker anymore. I play it because like if I don't see the Bunbuku, my low scale I'm always searching is Monkey Board, which gives you Joker, which gets you Dissolver. So then that way your field spell can just search anything but Sky Iris, or the Sky Iris if you want the Revolution. But this is great. I wouldn't play any more than one of each of these. And the last Pendulum, Morphage Sloth. It's for the Seals combo. Card's broken. The amount of times I made this on people and they tried to punch over it, but it couldn't be destroyed by battle and they just like scooped. Crazy. Triple Fenrir. Card's nuts. It's just good. Free advantage. Discard the second one off of Majesty Maiden. Triple Magnemut. You have to play him. Tier. Druswarm. Just outs boards.
Did you see them when you needed them?
Yeah, most of the time. I know a lot of people are playing six or they're playing seven. I chose the four just because I wanted to play other cards in my deck.
And four felt like it was enough?
Yeah, four was enough. I saw it when I needed it. I played four tier and I only lost to two of them because of time. So it wasn't like they were just making insane boards. The most questionable thing I played, 2-2 Imperm. This came up an insane amount of times against Flu. I played it twice, but the amount of time that I Ash Imperm them in those games was just insane. So they just couldn't play because, I mean, they didn't play around it, so they just got hit by it every time. And then playing Sprite, hitting their Gigantic, playing Tier, hitting their, like, a Mil 5 or something whenever they seem like they have really low resources was pretty good. So it was kind of insane, but I don't think I'd take these out. I think I like them better than playing the other Bestials.
It also gives you, like, a lot more, like, variance in what you can mess with, yeah. Too.
And it just gives you, like, better options going second. So, and, like, if you draw a Bestial against, like, Flu or something, it's just dead. But if you draw an Ash and a Bestial, then you have something, you know, instead of seeing two Bestials.
Yeah.
Three Denim is charge. Most people play one, if not two. But, you know, you're playing three Bunbuku to search your Majesty. So you're playing three of the Dynamis and three of the Dynamis charge. This card is so freaking broken. The amount of times I saw it and then was just able to get a free search and then pop it, send it to graveyard, so that way I could have another spell for Selene and get a free Sky Iris search. It was just insane. There was one time where I opened up three of these and I was playing second against Tier and I broke their board and set up the extra deck lock, and then they just couldn't play. So it might seem kind of cloggy playing so many of this one, but it's really not that bad. It's just extra names.
Did you ever break on it in a tournament?
No. The one time I would have bricked on it, I drew three of them and I broke the board and won the game. And it was a game one. So, like, it just didn't matter.
Just win the game, yeah. Easy.
I mean, it's like...
Just win the game.
I got you.
It's like, I opened up, like, the best combo, and then I opened up, like, a Magnemut or something. So, like, this right here is, like, the best combo you can open up. And then I had a Magnemut to get me a Revolution. And then I drew into, like, just another Draco Slayer name. So it was just, like, it was just kind of free playing into their board. I played the one Rota. I maybe saw this once or twice, but it just searches Ignis, and it's just like a way to have extra names of all the ones, all the good Draco Slayers. Ignis is all right, but he's better to see with Bluster or Majesty. The one I've called by, always play it, card's broken.
So what were you scared of with the call by, or was it just another piece of interaction if you went first?
I mean, mainly I just didn't want to get hand trapped.
Like, I know a lot of people are dropping it.
Yeah, a lot of people are dropping it, but, like, I know a lot of people are playing hand traps and Sprite, so I don't want to get hand trapped on my Beyond the Pendulum or Majesty that I really need. So it was there for that, but also too, like, if I'm playing against a Tier and they have an S, I have this to stop whatever they want. And if not, if they whiff and I just keep this in hand, then I have it for next turn. So it's essentially just like a sixth Bestial or hand tap. Okay. Hand trap protection.
So if that card would be swapped out, it'd probably be like another Bestial.
Yeah, probably. But I think
you like the call by more.
Yeah, it's also a spell too, so that helps for Selene. So.
Oh, okay.
That's,
yeah.
That's the better thing. The Sky Iris, it's just broken. The protection of scales never really comes up, but Searching Revolution is insane, and Dissolver, you can search it too. And then the last card I played was Zombie World. Most people aren't playing Zombie World in the main. They're playing Necro Valley. But I played this just because the end board you set up, Tier could never play through it. So if you just stack this on top of it, Flu can try to play through it. But even if they can't, they have to open up like Lightning Storm evenly in the main to be able to out it. And that's not going to get them all the way there. So it's kind of insane. But every Flu player I played against game one, I just slapped this up on top of my end board. And they were like, oh, you main Zombie World. And then they just
get lost.
So
did you see a lot of Flu?
I played two. But, like, I won every game one because of Zombie World. So, like, if I went second, I just broke their board, searched it, put it up, and, like, had this plus a negate, and they couldn't play. Or I just went first and did this blind every single time. It was pretty insane. It's also decent against Tier.
Yeah, they can't make Kaleidos.
Yeah, they can never make Rukalos. So they can never get to Kit, which they can never make Rukalos. Yeah, unless they see Instant Fusion. But, you know. So extra deck, XYZs. You play Magister Paladin. Card's broken. Summons another Draco from the extra deck. Searches for a Pendulum during end phase. Card's insane. Also super beautiful. Baguska. Card's insane against Flu. The amount of times I made this just to stall and then just ended up comboing. Just insane. And then I played the Ptolemaeus package for the Diamond. It's insane. You make this on every end board. And if you're playing against Sprite, it forces them to go away from Sprint because they can't send. So they just make Gigantic first. You negate the Gigantic, destroy it, and they can't play. And then, you know, if not, then anything playing Ishizu cards or Tier, they just can't mill. So this was a really good card to end on all day. especially playing four tier and three sprite. It was insane. This card just put in so much work, negated so many gigantics game one. Also, all the ulties, peep them. Beautiful.
All the rest of us poor.
Yeah, sorry, I forgot. Yeah, the reason why I topped is not because I played a better deck or I'm a better player, because you're all poor. And I had the ulties. That's really why. Hope Harbinger was the last XYZ. This came up sometimes, mainly it was just to make it if I knew I was playing against Flu, like game three, to put this on top of the end board just to have extra negate for like map or something. But other than that, it never really came up. I think I made it like maybe once against Sprite because I knew like the only card they had in their hand was like a starter or something that they didn't set. That's all the XYZs. Synchros, just playing it too. I'm not playing Baron. I'm not playing Savage. I'm not playing Omega. I'm just playing the two Ignister Provenance. This card's insane. It's broken. You have to play two. The amount of times I make two of this, link it off, summon it back again, Zalantis, both of them back, like just breaking people's boards. It was so ridiculous. This card's insane.
Did you ever miss the third?
No, I never missed the third, or I never missed like a Savage or like an Omega or anything. Cause like, to me, it's like, if you're making the Savage, it's just to bait out a Bestial. And the only reason you're baiting out a Bestial is like, if you have to do a very specific like two card combo, that's the only reason why you need to bait out a Bestial ever. But most, I mean, you're playing with five cards and you're playing like 25 Draco Slayer names, so you're bound to see more than just the two.
It wasn't worth just having to take out the diamond package.
Yeah, it really wasn't, because yeah, the diamond package is what takes up the space for like the Baron package or the Savage package or something. I mean, the Savage is just the one card, but I chose to play something else over the Savage, but this was this is all I felt like I needed, really. Board breaking potential and everything else. It was pretty good. I played the Vortex and the Dynasty Power. This card's insane. Protect Sloth by Battle and Card Effect, so they just can never play from the extra deck. This card is seriously underrated. If you ever play the Mirror Match and you have this and they don't, you just recycle your Revolutions over and over and they just cannot play. They cannot keep up because you have infinite copies of Revolution and they only have three. So they just can never keep up. Also, too, if you summon this, you can bounce a card. And then if you make Zalantis, banish everything, and special summon them back, you can bounce another card because it's just whenever it's special summon. So it's pretty good. I did that a lot. Like, turn two after they pass, I would just banish everything, summon their monster back and attack and just bounce it. So that was pretty good. Also, just Omni Negate, really, really useful. Seals, card's broken, extra deck lock. The amount of times you make this, like, if you make this plus Vortex, you beat Flu every time, unless they open up, like, one of their board breakers. But if not, then you have the bounce to interrupt the map, you have the negate to stop the Eagle and search, and they can never play. Beyond the Pendulum, this card's insane. I wanted to play two, but I don't think I needed to. It never really came up having the second one. And anytime it would have came up, I just like made Baguska, or I shuffled it back with Ignister and then just made Baguska just to stall. Not stall for time, but just to, you know, stall the game out a little bit.
Stall for time.
No. Hey, I only hit one person and they were playing Melfi Sprite, so they deserved it.
Oh my God.
They deserved to get burned for time. This card, it's insane, dude. It's almost better than Electromite. In a weird way, just because it's two effect monsters, including a pendulum. It doesn't have to be two pendulums. So your Fenrir's, your Beast Shields, they just get so much value, especially like summoning a Drewswarm and then linking it off with this to chain block. It's just insane. Selene, best girl, summons out your Dissolver. it summons out Synchron if you're playing the Baron package. The amount of times I just left this on board to Secret Village somebody, or it was just insane. There was one time I ended up gaining like eight counters and I'm just like, remove three. And they're like, dang, that's crazy. You could do it on my turn too. And I was like, yeah, I'd link it off. And it just didn't matter. So
you're going to say best girl when Beyond the Pendulum is literally right there. Right on top of
the hang on. Let's be honest. Okay, look. This is like the stepping stone just to get to Selene. So this is like, this card searches what you need for Selene, but you know, Selene is the only reason why that card's playable. So, you know.
Well, it's also a spellcaster.
It's also a spellcaster. They're both spellcaster.
It's a spellcaster. Easy.
Yeah, but I mean,
spellcaster your best.
Also, too, like, okay, hang on, I'm not gonna lie. Actually, this card's underrated in my opinion. Yeah, because the amount of times I activated Serene and then somebody just said Chain Magnum, hit your Beyond the Pendulum, and I was like, that's cool, dude. Go ahead.
Summon from hand.
Yeah. Opelousas. So I played this over playing the Savage. It came up a couple of times, but it was just like turn two. After they broke my board and said they broke the extra deck lock, but they couldn't set up a board, I was able just to like get rid of the rest of their stuff and then like slap a Opelousas and have like Opelousas plus Vortex, and it was enough. So, but other than that, it really never came up. It's just there for like if you play against Flu Game 3, you're setting up like Oppo, Hope, Harbinger, and Zombie World, and they can't play. And then the most broken card in the extra deck, this card's getting fucking banned. It's insane. Atlantis. Everybody's asked what the second effect does, and I tell them it literally is never going to resolve, but I explain it anyways. But the first effect is all you know. It just banishes everything, and then you resummon it however you want. Face up or in face down defense position. So face up attack or defense or face down defense. It's insane.
Well, how many cards in your extra deck are soft once per turn that like you reset with it?
This is technically a soft once per turn, but you can never use it because you can't detach. But yeah, just mainly you're resetting these two.
Your shufflers.
Shufflers or like your summons from the deck, summons from grave. Like you're just resetting those. There was one time though that it came up where I made like a Baguska, had it in defense for two turns, switched it to attack, played, and killed like their double and pin, and then. I made Zalantis, and then Zalantis put it back in defense, and then just passed, and the guy was so mad because he couldn't play. Because, you know, he's like, oh, he turned it to attack, it's over, I have everything, and then I just put it back in defense, and he's like, oh, you're so lame. And then the next time it died, and I just switched my monster to attack and killed him, so.
And the man's playing Flu, why is he calling
Yeah, he's
that,
playing Flu wild. And calling me lame, you know, like, come that's on, dude. Wild. Flu doesn't have this many ulties in the extra, come on. No.
So, what did you play?
What do you mean?
What'd you play against?
Oh,
you said that was two Flu?
I played two Flu, four Tier, and three Sprite, and then one of them was Melfi Sprite, and then I played one of them was Cash Tierra Tier.
Which one was the hardest matchup for you?
The hardest matchup was the guy who just got second at the YCS Minneapolis. He was playing Flu, and it was literally just because it was the most unwinnable game. That was like the game
they
three.
Just opened insane.
Yeah, you know, Map, Rabina, Nib. Imperm Cosmic, and then the last card was Impin. So he literally just nibbed me. He had the Cyclone for the Zombie World, and he stopped my Beyond the Pendulum search. And then he was just like, cool, activate Map, reveal Rabina. He normal summoned, and he banished the Eaglin. So he added the Eaglin, added Statue. Summoned Eaglin, I ashed him, and I was like, oh, for sure, I'm good. He's just going to set up Statue. I got three cards in hand with scales, I'm good. And then he's like, dang, that's crazy. Summon Impin, and it's just, you know, so this is like the only time drawing Impin was good.
Just got Impin.
But
yeah, when your full board was all, the game was just free.
Yeah. Then side deck, I played Triple Shifter. This came in every time against tier, and it only mattered one time. And it was because they didn't have the answer to it. So it got orange lighted one time, it got called bide, and it got gamma. So.
And then the Spice.
Oh, yeah. The Spice, the best card in the
game. Yes, indeed.
Best card. The amount of times I just made this with the seals and then a Majesty Maiden on board, it was just insane.
I walked past that in play for you like twice.
Yeah, I started doing it actually like after around like 4 or 5.
I saw you do it once and then it just every time you came back, you're like, oh, guess what I just did.
Yeah, so it was just like every time after that. I mean, you just like people aren't playing through this with the Majesty Maiden on board because they can't kill the Majesty Maiden because of this. They can't kill the Sloth because of this. And then the only thing they can have to out it is evenly matched, and they have to have two evenly matched, or they have to have evenly matched like Imperm.
And then it'll beat Sprite because half the deck is...
Exactly. Half the deck is spells. If they're playing Runic, they can't play. I did this against Tier every time because they always sided in Dark Ruler. So the amount of times Tier opened up like double Field Spell Dark Ruler and then just couldn't play through it was insane. Like, that was my favorite thing, was making people brick on their searcher. That was the best thing all Saturday. Necro Valley, just for Tier. It's good. It made it like once.
So if you had to pick out of which ones you make against Tier, like, do you side both of the Field Spells in against Tier, or do you just
I side both of these in, and it's like, if they end on a mediocre board, I'm probably going for the Secret Village. If not, I'm going to try to break their board and establish Necro Valley, like Necro Valley Diamond or something, so that way they have two things they have to out. And it's just because, like, if I make Diamond, they can't mill, but they can shuffle back with Mudora or something. But if I put Necro Valley down first, they are going to attempt to shuffle back to try to out it. Or if they don't have any shufflers, then just activating Necro Valley, you're making Diamond. They can't mill, they can't shuffle things back, so they can never out either of them with the field spell.
So the whole goal was to have the two targets instead of just, like, it doesn't replace it. It's just an additional one with it.
Yeah, yeah. So these were always coming in. This was mainly for, like, going first, but against tier, because I'm playing the Bestials, the Shifters, and whatnot, like, if I just drew a really good hand against them, I would just break their board and establish, like, Secret Village, plus, like, Vortex, and then, like, Diamond.
So going against them, which one do you pick first? You personally? Well, yeah, like, if you're going first against them, which one of them?
I'm going first at Secret Village every time, just because it stops everything. Because, you know, they're going second, so they're going to side in all their board breakers and stuff and field spells, and it stops them from having important cards. Speaking of which, Triple Dark Ruler. Dude, the amount of times I hit a flute player or something with this, it was insane. It really wasn't the spiciest card, but it was pretty good.
I mean, it ends games.
Yeah, it ends games. I mean, you just break their board, establish the extra deck lock, and then they can't play. Triple Evenly. This card also insane. Resolved it, like, twice against Flu and won that match, so it's pretty good. Time card. Scarlight. Burn. Yeah, boo, but we have to play. It literally just only came up against the Melfi player. And because I lost 8 dice rolls, it could have came up had I won, but... Or won the dice rolls a couple more times. Best card in the side deck. Triple Book of Eclipse.
How many times did you resolve it?
I resolved this card a whopping, like, 3 times. And every time it won me the game, or it just got negated. And one of the times I was playing against the Melfi Sprite, and I tried to make a play where I Baguska'd him, and then made Scarlight, activated it, and he was like, oh, it's just going to get negated. He's like, that's fine. And then I chained Book of Eclipse to Book of Eclipse and everything. So that way, everything died. Unfortunately, he had an Imperm, so, and it was in the Imperm column.
Oh.
But that was, like, the spiciest time it came up. Other
that
than
whole
that,
matchup just sounds like it was the worst game.
Oh, dude, it was terrible.
For both of you.
It was pretty painful to watch, not gonna lie.
But other than that, dude, it was just, like, every time I resolve this against tier, it's like, oh, they can't activate Sulik or Crime. That's crazy. Or it just got crimed, so...
So it came in against tier?
Yeah, it came up against tier. It was mainly in there in case I played, like, the tier cash Tira, because if for some reason they just, like, pop off and make an insane board, if they Shangri-La one of my zones, I lose. Like, these zones are the most important thing, and I didn't know if anybody was going to be playing pure cash Tira there, but if so, I was like, I just wanted to have an out. Also doubts the Ra's Disciple lock. Fun fact, you Book of Eclipse the Disciple... You make Zalantis. Zalantis summons the cards to the owner's field, so then you just give them back their Ra's Disciple, and you just hit them with the Uno reverse card until you're ready to kill them. Which is the funniest thing. I didn't play any branded, but I did it a lot in testing against them, actually, where I was just like, oh, Book of Moon, make Zalantis, give it back. Or, like, they would steal my... people were stealing my Fenrir's or my Magnemuts and stuff, and I'm like, cool, give it back. Oh, it was special summoned? Effect to search. So that was kind of insane too. But
awesome. All right, well, thanks for the deck list. How do you feel like the deck performed and how you played overall?
I felt like it played really well, especially since I lost 8 out of 9 dice rolls. It had to be the deck or me, or both, but I think I played really well because I don't think you lose 8 dice rolls and still get your invite, you know. But it was pretty insane, but the board breaking power of this deck is just kind of ridiculous once you think about it. Like, if you just get, like, your one Majesty Search off, you're just making double Ignister on them every time, and then Zalantis thing, and, you know, shuffling 4 cards and putting the other things face down. So it was pretty ridiculous.
And it was a pretty big event too. Like, how many people were there?
415.
Yeah, 415. So yeah, that was pretty nice. It was a pretty decent size, but. All I played against was meta, so I didn't get any of, like, the heroes or anything that was there.
The one hero deck that top 8ed.
Awesome. Yeah, the one hero deck that top 8ed. It was insane.
Honestly. All right, well, thanks, and everyone, welcome the return of the Pen God.
Yeah, the return of the Pen God.
All right. You have any shout-outs or anything before we get done?
Oh, shout-out Jordan, the driver, the chauffeur. Nick, my brother, obviously, Randall, he was there. He also, meet him. I mean, he taught me kind of how to play the game when I was growing up, but really just like going over deck theory. He kind of taught me how to deck build, so I kind of got some of the spice from him.
But the fun ofs.
Yeah, the fun ofs, not the one ofs.
The fun ofs.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks for the deck profile.